Hey guys, this is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll take a look at how to apply the screen pump effect to your video clips. This effect is very simple, and when applied at the right time, to the right clip, can look very cool. Let's take a look at how it's done. Skim your clip in your timeline, and place your playhead where you want to apply the screen pump effect. Place a marker in this frame by pressing M on your keyboard. Use the left arrow key to go back 2 frames from your marker. From the drop-down menu, select the Transform tool and add a keyframe here by clicking the keyframe button. Move your playhead back to your marker and, with the clip selected, in the inspector, increase the scale all slider to about 115%. Move your playhead ahead 2 more frames with the right arrow key and reset the scale all slider back to 100%. Close the Transform tool. This is what we have so far. If you want to change the timing of this effect, select the clip in your timeline and press Ctrl V to show video animation. Here, you can drag the 2 end keyframes further apart to slow down this effect, or closer together to speed it up. Next, let's add some fake motion blur to our clip to make this look even better. Place your playhead on the first keyframe, open the effects browser, and select the blurs category. Drag and drop the zoom blur effect to apply to your clip. In the inspector, drag the amount slider down to 0 and add a keyframe here. Move your playhead to your middle keyframe and bring the amount slider all the way up. If you want to add even more blur to your clip, click and hold the number beside the slider and drag up. This allows you to go past the predetermined max amount of 32. I'll set mine to about 75. Next, move your playhead to the last keyframe and bring the amount slider back down to 0. Optionally, you can add more effects to your clip. For example, from the distortions category, we can add a wave effect to our clip. Keyframe it the same way you did the blur effect. So, on the first keyframe, bring the amount down to 0. For the middle keyframe, bring up the amount slider to whatever value looks good, and back down to 0 on the last keyframe. Try this one, or any of the hundreds of effects available in Final Cut Pro. See what cool look you can come up with, and do this as many times as you need in your clip. This is what mine looks like. Now, to make things simpler, and to save you some time, I made this effect available for free as a title download. Click on the link in the video description and download the file from my website. Drag it out to your desktop and double click on the download to unzip it. Next, open Finder and go to your home folder by using the keyboard shortcut Shift Command H. Open your movies folder, then open motion templates and titles. Drag and drop your downloader folder into this location. Close Finder and restart Final Cut Pro. To apply your new effect, skim your clip and place your playhead on the exact frame where you want this effect applied to. Hit the left arrow key 4 times to go back 4 frames. Next, open your Titles and Generators browser, select Titles, and scroll down to the SM Screen Pump category. Select one of these clips and press Q to connect edit it to your timeline. You can apply this as many times as you need to your clip, and edit any of the available parameters in the inspector. Enjoy! If you found this video helpful, check out the playlist linked in the video description for more cool Final Cut Pro effects. Thanks for watching, I'll see you back here next week.